Our episode starts with an entourage of people getting out of a van which includes two mysterious women. As they get out, they're ambushed by some assassins. After they chase the assassins off, the dark-haired woman, whose name is Bianca, comes to Harry Preston's home looking for his help. He tries to get rid of her as he's attempting to have a romantic night with a woman. The woman unhappily takes off in what seems to be jealousy. Bianca mocks Harry's love issues before revealing she's a vampire as she fangs out while asking for his help regarding her attempted assassination.
Happy now?
Thank you. Harry, I want to hire you.
Forget it.
Oh, I don't forget anything. Remember what I did for you? It's payback time.
Via flashback, we find out that Bianca once saved Harry when he was in a jam years ago, and they even had a romantic relationship. A pass she's now using as a You Owe Me card to get Harry to agree to help.
Just kill me. Kill me.
No.
Kill me!
I'm not done with you yet.
Later, Bianca, along with her protege Natalie, approach Harry with leftover evidence from the attempted hit that he uses to magically review what happened. Harry tells Bianca that the hit was performed by a guy named Clive. Bianca assumes he was sent by the Vampire Council, and Natalie wants his head, but Harry convinces her to calm down and let him do some investigating. Harry goes asking questions around Chicago to various council members regarding what he saw and eventually is kidnapped by Clive, wanting to know why he's going around accusing him of trying to assassinate anyone, as he claims to be retired from the business and just living a normal life with a family. Just then, a group breaks into where they're being held and takes out Clive and his crew. Clive's last words is, "It's my granddaughter's birthday." Harry, once he escapes, storms at Bianca's club, accusing them of taking out Clive. Bianca claims to be innocent, and when he specifically points the finger at Natalie, who threatens Clive's life earlier, she basically says she couldn't have done it because they have a lot of witnesses to their whereabouts, basically insinuating they were having an orgy at the time. Back at Harry's place, he's confronted by representatives of the council, who try to beat him into revealing Bianca's whereabouts, but he doesn't rat her out. The council's representative gives Harry a pair of magic handcuffs and orders him to use them on her if he sees her. As they leave, Bianca appears from the shadows and claims that she's being set up. It's deduced that whatever is going on has something to do with a drug called Third Eye, which acts as a vampire steroid of sort, and that the two need to work together to get to the bottom of what's going on. After doing some magic at a warehouse, they head to a vampire named Arvin's place and find proof that he was involved in setting up Clive. They find Arvin curled up tweaking off of Third Eye, who was no help due to being an addict. When he doesn't help, she kills him. Going into his hand, she ends up cutting herself on a vial laced with Third Eye, which makes her rage. Harry then has to attack her with magic and knocks her out until the effects of the drug wears off.
I cut myself.
That's not good. Bianca. Don't make me do this, please.
You can't hold me here forever.
Bianca, you gotta help me here. It's the Third Eye. You gotta get a hold of yourself.
Once she comes to, she gets up believing she's figured out that her ex-business associate slash boyfriend Jake was the person setting her up, as he once wanted to deal Third Eye out of the club, and she disagreed. Harry insists on helping her, when she tries to do it herself, but she eventually agrees to allow him to get involved. Bianca asks Jake to meet her at Clive's warehouse, and they have a standoff where Bianca accuses Jake of the setup. Jake, though, has no clue what Bianca is talking about, As they talk shop, they're ambushed by a group of hunters, led by Natalie. As Natalie does the Scooby-Doo villain monologue, giving up her plan, Dresden ambushes her and puts the cuffs on her, bringing the council to take her. The episode ends with Harry and Bianca having a drink together, talking about one day leading better lives, before she gives Harry a final kiss goodbye, promising to do everything she can to not bother him again. Natalie in this episode is played by Laura Vandervoort, who does not fang out at any point. If you want to see that, you'll have to check out the Netflix series V-Wars. As for Bianca, she makes her final appearance in the series 3 episodes later when Harry is investigating the mysterious deaths of 3 young ladies that she has a connection to. She's very receptive to seeing Harry again up until he accuses her of doing something to the girls, in which her demeanor then completely changes and the fighting turns into a knockdown, drag-out fight.
Bianca, I got 4 dead bodies, 3 of them innocent girls, and you're connected to all of it. Now, what do you know, and what did you do to them?
Me hurt Linda. Get out.
I want answers, Bianca.
Good night, Dresden.
What did you do to them? Bianca, no more games.
I got 3 girls. Grace, Jennifer, and Linda. What do you know about them?
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to know when I update and check out the channel playlist, which I regularly update with free vampire media featuring female bloodsuckers available on YouTube.